This is a 24 kilowatt hour Nissan Leaf, and in this video I'm going to show you how you change the reduction gearbox oil. And this applies to all Leafs, whether it's a 24, 30 or 40 kilowatt hour Leaf. So what is your reduction gearbox? Well, basically it's a single speed gearbox. So this is the electric motor, and the reduction gearbox is bolted on the end of the motor. You've then got a differential in here, and then you've got your half shafts there going out on the other side to your front wheels. And then you've got oil in this gearbox, lubricating the gears in the reduction gearbox and also lubricating that differential. So your next question is going to be, how often do you have to change that oil? Well, according to Nissan, you don't. It's sealed for life. It's not part of their standard service schedule. However, reduction gearboxes can be a weak point on EVs, and reduction gearboxes on Leafs are known to fail. It's not a common problem at all, far from it. But changing the oil can only help. Whether it's solved that, I doubt it, but it can only help, and it's a very cheap and easy thing to do. So as to when you should change it, there's no definite answer. This car's done 54,000 miles. I'm getting it ready for resale and doing a service on it, and I'm changing the oil now. And that's the sort of level I think they should be changed at, every sort of 50, 60 or 70,000 miles or so. But as always with oil, changing it early is only going to help. So what we'll do in this video as well is have a look at the state of the oil in this car. This has done 54,000 miles. It's never been done before, so it'll be interesting to see what this one looks like. So next, the tools you're going to need. I'm going to put a link to everything in the video description below. So go there to find out everything you need to get before you do the job. And the oil, you need 1.4 litres of Nissan Matic S. And like all OEMs, they hide what these oils are. They hide the oil and fluid specs, so you buy it from them, of course. But it's basically a synthetic ATF oil. And if you Google Nissan Matic S, you'll soon find a list of other oils which meet or exceed that specification. In this case, this is one of them. It's a Coma MV ATF Plus oil I'm using. So you do need to get underneath the car, because you've got to drain the oil from the gearbox and also remove that front under tray. So obviously health and safety is key. You've got to know how to properly lift and support the vehicle before you get underneath it. Do not take any risks. I'm not going to cover how you do that here, and I would suggest if you don't know how, then maybe you should be paying a garage to do the job for you. But in this case, I've got it on a four-post lift here, obviously, but you don't actually need much space. You've only got to take that under tray out and then drain the oil. You can do the refilling from the top if you want to use a bit of hose and a funnel. So anyway, let's go through the steps. So first off, you've got to remove this under tray. And if it's an old Leaf like this, that's probably going to be the most difficult job. The under tray looks like that, and there are 5 10mm bolts holding the front on, one in the back, and the rest are just plastic clips, so really easy. The problem you find is these 10mm bolts tend to rust and can be very difficult to remove. In this case, that back one came out okay, but all these front ones, so I think one was okay, but 4 I had to cut out with an angle grinder because they were just so rusted up. The spring clips that go on the back were just turning, and I had to drill and cut the bolts out. But this car is 9 years old, and clearly this under tray has never come off before, because all of these bolts were absolutely rusted solid. But as part of a normal service schedule, unless you're changing the oil or replacing anything, there isn't a need to take this tray off. So that's the issue you can come up against. It's just simply rusted bolts. And in my case, that one, that one, that one, and then the one here which attaches to this bit of tray were all rusted, and I've got to, I've still got to cut that one out, well, drill that out and drill that one out and replace the bolts, and then that spring clip, U-nuts, I think you call them, or maybe chimney nuts. But yeah, that's the most difficult part of the job. If it's old and rusty, because the front here gets all the weathering, and on all vehicles these tend to rust up. So next you've got to get the oil out of the gearbox, and what you need for that is a 10 millimeter Allen key end, and you're probably going to want a long bar because these are quite stiff initially, particularly if it's never been done before in this case. But what you need to do is always undo and remove the fill plug first and then the drain plug, for two reasons. Firstly, if you remove the drain plug first and all the oil comes out and then you can't get this one undone, you're knackered, you're not going to be able to fill the gearbox back up. And secondly, when the fill plug is out and then you remove the drain plug, it allows the air to come into the gearbox and the oil will then pour out nice and smoothly without any glugging and splashing. So I have already loosened these off, so they're not too tight. Let me just get the oil tray underneath in case anything comes out of the fill plug. There's the fill plug. We'll look at the debris on the magnet in a minute. And then this is the drain plug. So we'll remove that. Oh, bugger. That's trouble doing this job one-handed. I didn't have that in the right place. Anyway, I can already see from that, and all the oil running down my arm, and all the oil on the floor, that looks very clean. So I've never done that before. Never got it so spectacularly wrong, but anyway, I can't refilm it. Can't put the oil back in the gearbox, so you'll see my mistakes. But anyway, that's the trouble. When you're holding a camera, looking through the lens of the camera, or looking at the viewfinder, the little screen, and also trying to do something with one hand and talking at the same time, it's difficult to multitask sometimes. Anyway, here's the fill plug, there's the drain plug. So they are pretty clean. There's some swarf on there, but no big chunks, which is good to see, particularly on the drain plug there, because any chunks are going to go to the bottom. And that is looking very good for 54,000 miles. For a Nissan, I've seen some pretty horrible chunks before, but that is looking very, very good. So I've now removed the oil on both. I think that's focusing. But this is the drain plug. So very little debris on that one. This is the fill plug. And again, very little on that one. So obviously you've got to clean these up, get all the rubbish off, replace the washers either with a copper washer or an aluminium crush washer. Again, I'll put the sizes that you need in the video descriptions below so you can get those before you do the job. And then obviously you put your drain plug in. These are both identical, by the way. You put your drain plug in back first, do that up tight, then fill it with oil, and then put your fill plug in, and you fill it with oil until the oil dribbles out. And obviously you've got to make sure your car is on the level as well. So I'm going to clean these up and I'll crack on and do the rest of the job. So I've got my new washer on the drain plug, and the oil has finished dripping out of there. So do that up. And these have got to be 34.5 Newton meters, which is that much. I was a little bit out. There, it's that much. So next is simply a case of filling the oil through the fill plug here until the oil level reaches the threads on the fill plug. So I'm going to do it with a syringe, sucking it straight out the bottle, which I'm not going to do it on camera because means getting the tripod out, and you probably really don't need to see that. But the other way you could do it is you could do it from above, from the engine compartment, from under the bonnet, and you could run a bit of PVC hose into there using a funnel. You could pour it from above, or if you've got bottles with a hose, you could get it up into there and get it in that way. But anyway, that should be 1.4 litres to fill that up to the point where it starts dribbling back out. So that's filled up. Drain plug is in. I haven't nipped it up yet. I'm just going to get all the oil off here, because then you can obviously check for any leaks. And then as the other one, 34.5 newton meters. So now it's just a case of putting that under tray back on and you're done. And that is just a number of these plastic clips, I'm not sure whether that's focusing, and five of these 10 millimeter bolts, which is on the floor. And then you're done. It's as simple as that. It's a very quick and simple job. Getting access and getting this under tray off are the most difficult parts of it. Anyway, that's it for this video. As I said, everything's in the video description below. So have a read of that, and also there's a link there to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made on the Nissan Leaf. If you found this video useful, please do click the thumbs up button, really does help. Do subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you on the next video.